So s is equal to root 2. So from there we can see sine 45 will be opposite over hypotenuse. If I'm using this 45, opposite is 1, hypotenuse is root 2. So that's 1 over root 2. You can rationalize this. Since I have 1 over root 2, you can rationalize by multiplying both numerator and denominator by root 2. 1 times root 2 will give me root 2. Root 2 times root 2 will be root 4, which is same thing as 2. So this one can also be equal to root 2 over root 2, whichever one is fine. Now, cos 45 as well, it is its opposite. Now, let's say we are using this 45. Here is the hypotenuse. This is opposite. So that means here will be the adjacent. The adjacent will also be 1 over hypotenuse, which is also the same thing as root 2 over 2. Which is also the same thing as root 2 over 2. So that's what we have. So at the end of the day, tan theta, tan 45, opposite over adjacent. Opposite 1 over adjacent 1. So that means tan 45 is 1. So that means sine 45 is 1 over root 2 or root 2 over 2. Cos 45, 1 over root 2 or root 2 over 2. Tan 45 is 1. So sine 45 and cos 45 are the same. 1 over root 2. So it remains the last one. We want to check the special angle for 30 and 60. Given an equilateral triangle, equilateral triangle means that all sides are equal and all the angles are equal. Since the sum of angles in a triangle is 180 and all the angles are equal, so that means all of them will be 60, 60, 60. So, let us take length. Let's say this length is 2 units. If this place is 2, this one too will be 2. Because it is an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle means that all the sides are equal and all the angles are equal. So I will divide this equilateral, let me call it angle ABC. ABC. Now I will divide this equilateral triangle into two equal halves this way, so that I will have, when I divide it into two equal halves, this place will be 90 degrees. Since this place is 2 and I've divided it into 2 equal halves, this place will be 1. The other side 2 will be 1. This place 2 will be 90. Since I've divided and here is 60, this place will be 30 degrees. This one 2 will be 30 degrees. This place will still be 60 degrees. Here will also still be 60 degrees. Here will be 2. Here will be 2. So it remains this place. I don't know what this length is, the height of this one. Let me call it H. The height H. So I will look for H using any of the two triangles. I can use any of the two triangles to find H. Now to find H, I'll use Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem, says that hypotenuse square equals opposite square plus adjacent square. This is hypotenuse. Where this one is facing is the hypotenuse. So here is hypotenuse. Anywhere can be the opposite. We can take this to be the opposite, or you can take why the third side will be the adjacent. So now, hypotenuse square, that's 2. 2 square is equal to opposite square, 1 square plus adjacent square. 2 square is 4, 1 square is 1 plus adjacent square. So bring this one to the other side. I have 4 minus 1 is equal to h square. 4 minus 1 is 3. 3 equal h square. So I have h square to be equal to 3. So if I take the square root of both sides, a should be equal to square root of 3. So if I try to redraw this, this place will be 2 now, here will be 30, here will be 60 degrees, here will be 1, and here will be root 3. I can actually take any value, even for this 45 degrees, I can take any value for this one, for this case. But to make life easy, I just take 1. Any value, no matter the value, if you take 3 here, it will also be 3, and this place will be 3 root 2. By the time you do sine 45, you have 3 over 3 root 2. You see that 3 will still cancel each other. The same thing, so I can take any length. But to make in order to make things in the lowest term, to make life easier, I decide to pick 2 like this. So we want to find sine 30, cos 30, tan 30, and like sine 30. Sine 30, that's, I'll go to 30, this is 30 degree, I'll work with respect to the 30. Here is the hypotenuse. This where this 90 degree is facing is the hypotenuse. Where this 30 degree, since I'm working with 30 now, where this 30 degree is facing is the opposite. That means the south side will be the adjacent. So, sine 30, opposite over hypotenuse. Opposite, 1. Over hypotenuse, 2. Sine 30 is 1 over 2, or what you call 0.5. Cos 30 will be equal to cos 30, adjacent over hypotenuse. Adjacent is root 3 over hypotenuse, 2. Root 3 over 2. Then lastly, tan. Tan 30. Tan 30, opposite over adjacent, opposite 1 over adjacent, root 3. You can rationalize this, this one will be root 3 over 3, just the way we rationalize this one. Now it rains sine 60, let's write it here, sine 60. Now, since I am looking for sine 60 now, things will change. The hypotenuse will still be the same. I'm working with sine 60. So where the 90 degrees facing is the hypotenuse. Where the 60 degrees is facing is the opposite. Why the last place will be the adjacent. So sine 60, opposite over hypotenuse. Opposite is root 3 over hypotenuse, 2. Cos 60, adjacent over hypotenuse, 1 over 2, 1 over 2, and lastly, tan 60, opposite over adjacent, opposite, root 3 over adjacent, 1, root 3 divided by 1 is still root 3. So obviously you can see that sine 30 and cos 60 are the same. Cos 30 and sine 60 are the same. The reason is just because of that first thing I gave you, that sine theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta. If you let theta be 30, that's sine 30. Cos 90 minus 30. 90 minus 30 will give me 60. So that's why sine 30 and cos 60 are the same. And so on like that. So that is for the right angle triangle. That is for the special angles. You need to take note of all those special angles. If I'm to write it now, so if I'm to write it in a tabular form, in a table, let's say I have 0 degrees, 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees, and lastly, 90 degrees. I have sine here. Cos and tan. So sine 0 is 0, sine 30 is 1 over 2, sine 45, root 2 over 2, sine 60, root 3 over 2, and sine 90, 1. Cos 0, 1. Cos 30, root 3 over 2. Cos 60, cos 45, root 2 over 2. Cos 60, 1 over 2. Cos 90, 0. Tan 0, 0. Tan 30, 1 over root 3, or root 3 over 3. Sin 40, tan 45, 1. Tan 60, tan 60 will give me root 3. And tan 90 is infinity. Now, before I leave this place, I want to show you a shortcut, a short way of remembering so far. A short way of remembering all these things. A short way of remembering these special angles. A shortcut to remember special angle. Now, let me show you shortcut to remember special angle. So, you will draw a tabular form this way. I've drawn it. How to remember without cramming, without anything, because students find it difficult, most times difficult, to remember what some don't know what sine 30 and what sine 60 is. They mistake it for each other. Now, let me show you. Write 0, 30, 45, 60, 90 this way. Then sine constant. I will show you how you can remember without any proof. I just gave you the proof, not like you have to be proving it whenever you need it. Whenever you need sine 45, you just use the 2 over 2. You don't need any proof to you don't need to be proving it when you need it. You get my point. So that's what I'm trying to say. Now, how do you remember all this? Let me tell you what how it is. Everything will have still everything you have, you have to write square root over 2. You can see what I've written there. Square root over 2. Write square root over 2 throughout. That means in this place as well, square root over 2, square root over 2, square root over 2, square root over 2. Good. As you can see what I'm trying to say, so what you need to remember in this case, if you want to use the shortcut, is that you write square root over 2 for everything. So you will start to see the way I write it. I've written the angles in ascending order. 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, and 90 degree. So write square root for sine, go to sine own for sine. Go to square root over 2, square root over 2, square root over 2, square root over 2, square root over 2. Then here, you start from 0. 0, 1. You see the way I'm filling it? 0, 1. Under the square root, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That is what you are going to have. Square root of 0 is 0. The square root of 0 is 0. Is 0 divided by anything? Is 0 divided by 2 is still 0. So that means sine 0 is 0. Square root of 1 is 1. So square root of 1 is 1. So square root of 1 is 1. Everything over 2. So that means this sine 30 is 1 over 2. Square root of root 2, square root of 2 does not, is not a perfect square. So I will be having 1.414, but I can leave it in short form this way. So that means sine 45 will be root 2 over 2. And of course, and that's what we have. Then root 3. Square root of 3, 2 cannot be it's not rational. 3 is not rational, root 3 is not rational. So I will leave it this way. That means sine 60 is root 3 over 2, and that's what we have. You can cross-check all what we've been solving so far. You see that they are accurately and they are very accurate and it's correct. Then for 90 degrees, square root of 4 is 2. 2 divided by 2 is what? 1. Square root of 4 is 2. 2 divided by 2 will give me 1. So that means sine 90 is 1. So we are done for sine. Done for sine. Now for cos, how to remember cos own. Once you've done for sine, to remember cos own is very simple. You start from the end. The end for sine, the end is 1. So that means you just need 1 here. The next one that follows is root 3 over 2. This one will be root 3 over 2. For the next, after I have 1, 1, root 3 over 2, root 3 over 2, root 2 over 2, root 2 over 2, 1 over 2, 1 over 2, then 0. That's what we are going to have. Then for the third one, for tan, tan is very easy. Don't forget I said tan theta is sine theta over cos theta. 0 divided by 1 is 1. 1 over 2 divided by 3 over 2, you will, if you do this calculation, or if you solve it, if you simplify it, you are going to have 1 over 3. Root 2 over 2 divided by root 2 over 2, obviously you will get 1. Root 3 over 2 divided by 1 over 2, you will get root 3. 1 divided by 0 will give you infinity. That's what we are going to obtain in this case, or in this contest. So now, I will just want to draw the sine graph and the cosine graph. Then we'll go to another aspect. We draw the sine and cosine graph. We go to another aspect of trigonometry. So for sine graph, let me just, I'm going to give a sketch on the sine graph. So I'm going to give you a sketch on the sine graph. So this is what I'm going to have. This is 0 degrees. And it goes on like that. It's no so dear. So the peak here is 1, while the bottom here is minus 1. This is sine graph, it goes on like that. This is sine graph. It starts from 0, so that's why sine 0 is 0. But when it comes to this place, this is half a circle or quarter of a circle. This is pi over 2. Pi over 2, pi is 180 in radians. Pi is 180 degrees. So when I say pi over 2, I mean 90. So at 90 you get to the peak. So that's why sine 90 is 1. Sine 90 is 1. It will from 0 to 90, it will increase till you get to 90. When you get to 90, sine 90 is 1. Then when it comes back, it will take another half. Here will be pi or 180. Here is 90. Here is another 90. Here is another 90, making 180. So that means sine 180 is 0. So by the time you come again to the next place, here is 3 pi over 2, that's 270. Just be adding 90, 180, 270. 3 pi over 2 is 270 because pi is 180 degrees. Yeah, that means sine 270. And if you press your calculator, sine 270 is minus 1. Sine 270 is minus 1. Then, by the time you complete another half, here will be 2 pi. 2 pi is 360. That's 2 times 180, 360. Sine 360 is another 0, and you have completed one circle like that. Everything starts again. If you want to get 450, it will be 1, and on like that. That's why, that's what we call sine graph. That's what we call sine graph. So now I will draw the cosine graph. I won't draw the tangent graph because it's not well, it's not really that complicated to draw, but I don't want to draw it. So to draw the cosine graph, is also like that. Cosine graph starts for sine graph. Sine graph starts from 0. Sine 0 is 0. But cosine graph, let's say this place is 1, start from 1 and it comes this way. And it goes on like that. Here will be minus 1. Well, this is a freehand sketch and it's not particularly drawn to scale. Now, what's this saying? This is cosine graph. So what happened here is that that's why cos 0 is 1. When it is 0, cos 0 is 1. But by the time it gets to this place, it's 90. Pi over 2, 90. Pi over 2 is 90. That means cos 90 is 0. By the time you have another half, by the time you have another half, this is 180 pi. You have 180 here, pi. So cos pi or cos 180 is minus 1. By the time you are done again, when you get to this place, this is 3 pi over 2, that's 270. When you have 270 here, cos 270 is 0. By the time it goes again to 360 degrees, this is 2 pi. That's 360 degrees. So that means cos 360 will be 1 again, because you can see it. Cos 360 will be 1 again. And on like that, and goes on like that. So that is what we call sine and cosine graph. So let's do some examples. Let's do some work examples. Let's do some work example. Example 7. Example 7. Example 7 says that given that cos alpha is equal to 4 over 5, where 0 degree is less than or equal to alpha, less than or equal to 90 degrees. Evaluate the following. The first one is I want to evaluate tan alpha. The second one, I want to do cosec alpha plus sec alpha. Then the third one, cos alpha plus sine alpha, everything over cosec alpha minus sine alpha. Then D, prove that sine square alpha plus cos square alpha is equal to 1. So we want to do this. We want to do this. We want to prove this. The first one is that I have cos alpha to be 4 over 5. Draw a right angle triangle. You draw a right angle triangle. Let this place be the alpha. This is the hypotenuse. Don't forget, cos. I have cos alpha. Cos alpha is 4 over 5. And cos alpha is adjacent over hypotenuse. So the adjacent is 4. This is opposite. So adjacent is 4. Hypotenuse is 5. Adjacent over hypotenuse. So I need to get this place. Say S. I need to get that place. Say S. So to get S, don't forget, by Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square, that's 5 square, is equal to opposite square plus adjacent square. This is 25, is equal to S square plus 16. Bring the 16 to the other side. I have 25 minus 16 is equal to S square. So I have 9 to be equal to S square. Then I can easily, or I say S square is equal to 9, then take the square root of both sides. S is equal to square root of 9, or S is equal to 3. So that means here, the answer here is 3. S is 3 in this case. So we want to solve, we want to solve. So at the end of the day, A, I have tan alpha. Tan alpha is to do tan. Tan is opposite over adjacent. Opposite over adjacent. Opposite in that question is 3 over adjacent 4. So the answer is 3 over 4. For the second one, I have cosec alpha plus sec alpha. Cosec is 1 over sine. This is 1 over sine alpha plus 1 over cos alpha. So what does that mean? Let us look for sine alpha first. Sine alpha is opposite over hypotenuse. That's 3 over 5. Cos alpha is adjacent over hypotenuse. That's also 4 over 5. And in reality, we have been given from the question that cos alpha is 4 over 5. So this is 1 over sine alpha. That's 1 over 1 over 1 over 3 over 5 plus 1 over 4 over 5. By the time you do all these ones, you have 5 over 3 plus this one, you get 5 over 4. So the LCM 12, 12 divided by 3, 4. 4 times 5, 20. Plus 12 divided by 4, 3. 3 times 5, 15. So that at the end of the day, I will have 35 over 12. You can leave it this way or you convert to the new to mixed fraction. The same question I want to do, I want to do cos alpha plus sine alpha all over cos alpha minus sine alpha. Cos alpha is 4 over 5. This is 4 over 5 plus 3 over 5. Everything divided by 4 over 5 minus 3 over 5. Our denominator, the LCM is 5. 5 divided by 5, 1. 1 times 4, 4. 4 plus 3. Everything over LCM is 5. 5 divided by 5, 1. 1 times 4, 4. Minus 5 divided by 5, 1. 1 times 3, 3. So that at the end of the day, I'm going to have 7 over 5. Then I can write this way, divided by 1 over 5. This one will be 7 over 5 multiplied by 5 over 1. 5 cancel 5, so that you will be left with 7 over 1. This is the same thing as 7. 5 will cancel 5 and you will be left with 7. So the fourth one, we want to prove that, we are going to prove that sine squared theta plus cos squared theta is equal to 1. So we'll start from sine squared theta plus cos squared theta now. I have sine squared theta plus cos squared theta. Sine theta is what? 3 over 5. That's 3 over 5 all squared plus cos theta 4 over 5 all squared. This will be equal to 9 over 25 plus 16 over 25. The LCM is 25. 25 divided by 25, 1, 1 times 9, 9. 25 divided by 25, 1, 1 times 16, 16. So this is 25 over 25. 25 divided by 25 will give me 1. So that means that, therefore, sine squared theta is sine squared alpha. I have changed my notation to theta. Sine squared alpha. Sine squared alpha plus cos squared alpha gives 1. That's what we have for that deep.